Please rewind this cassette.
So our story starts in 2007, as I go with my parents to a local drive-in. I know, does this story take place in the 70s? Well, what was the big movie playing that summer? Michael Bay's Transformers. Now, if you've been to a drive-in, you know that typically, they play two movies back-to-back. Sometimes you stay for the second movie, and a lot of the time most people leave before it even starts. How much cheap food, popcorn, and bug bites can one handle in an evening? On this night, the second film playing was a little gem known as Hot Rod. This was to be the breakout feature of SNL star Andy Samberg, with co-writers Akiva Schaffer and Jorma Taccone. At the time, I was a huge fan of their work and the SNL digital shorts that I found to be groundbreaking, so I was generally interested in seeing them make a movie. Then it started, and my mind was blown forever after. Hot Rod was a bomb, and at best, critics were mixed on this movie. Now, as the years have gone on, it's safe to say it's built a strong cult following, and many moments are often quoted from people of my generation. The most common being Cool Beans.
Cool Beans.
Cool Beans.
Cool Beans.
Cool Beans.
Cool Beans.
Cool, cool.
Beans.
Beans.
Cool
Beans.
Cool, cool.
Beans.
Beans.
Cool
Beans.
So why didn't this movie connect in 2007? Well, I don't want to sound crazy and say that Hot Rod was ahead of its time in both content and presentation, but it was. This was a comedy made for the YouTube generation. The editing, pacing, and rhythm of the humor is very much in line with those SNL digital shorts and stuff that was more common to find online and not exactly in a Hollywood movie. Looking back, everything about this thing was so 2007. But it's also sort of timeless because of its small scope within its story in the world. The supporting cast is loaded. A young Bill Hader, Danny McBride, Ian McShane as Rod's stepfather, who Rod wants to beat in a fight in order to gain his respect and love. Will Arnett playing his typical douchebag role that he's mastered. A lot of people look back on this era of the man-child comedy as immature and dated. I can see that point of view, but Hot Rod is something a lot of those other films lack. A heart. I feel the friendship between everyone working on this movie. You can tell it's a group of guys who love doing this and are having a blast with a budget and a studio backing them for the first time in their lives. It's in the way Hot Rod balances between being a studio comedy and a quirky little indie film with unique personality. There's so many good bits and scenes that showing them all here would be useless. Instead, let's take a moment to focus on the overlooked thing about this movie and why it's such a rewarding experience. The filmmaking. One thing that's always bothered me about the reception of this movie and its creators is how overlooked Akiva is as a director. While their later film Popstar would receive critical acclaim, a lot of the roots of that movie can be found here. Akiva has a fun and creative style to his camera work. He knows how to create energy within a scene, but also how to slow things down for nice character moments. And a lot of the time, this movie feels like a series of short films strung together into a single narrative. Standouts would be the acid sequence featuring Bill Hader telling his backstory to Rod while being driven to the hospital. This was based off a true story. The montage of Rod breaking down his plan to save Frank. And of course, the punch dancing scene. I guess a lot of people would say these are just a series of sketches, but I don't really agree with that. I would compare this more to Wayne's World in that it uses the sketch format but then finds a cinematic way of approaching it. The construct of this movie is its greatest strength, and instead of all the jokes feeling like one-offs, they all contribute to the mindset and worldview of our characters. Now, having said that, a lot of the jokes are Andy Samberg going to do some stunt and falling on his ass. This is without question the laziest part of this movie, but it's still fun for those who are fans of stuff like Tom Green or Jackass. In fact, I would say this movie is very much a parody of that format, with these guys being inspired by it, but also being unable to really pull it off. I just love the music choices. I love how sometimes things just get weird. I love how this movie never tries to be more than what it is, but it's also surprising in that it does more than it should. Comedy, they say, is subjective. Critics and audiences often differ on what they consider to be good in the genre. A lot of critically panned comedies go on to be classics, and a lot of the ones that critics love seem forgotten within 5 years. So where does that put us with Hot Rod? Can you give any kind of objective analysis of this movie's merits? What if someone just says to me, "I didn't think that was very funny, dude"? Well, while I'm not going to try and argue that the whole comedy is subjective thing isn't true, I do think people oversell that in a way to ignore having a discussion about comedic writing and its merits and even the morality of it. Some people don't have any sense of humor, and a lot of people just have a bad sense of humor that they defend with the subjective argument. Then there's people like me who consider themselves comedy nerds who knew more than the average Joe and think they have no clue how to study and respect it. So yes, if you don't find Hot Rod funny, then it's just your opinion, and that is cool. However, I would just say that this movie not only works for me at making me laugh, it also impresses me and grows on me as a fine and well-made piece of entertainment. This was a perfect drive-in movie, and while as time has gone by, I don't find myself watching Transformers anymore, I've rewatched Hot Rod like a dozen times, and it's still great. I knew then, in the back of my parents' pickup truck, under the bright stars of a warm Texas night, this was a classic. And I do believe now, all these years later, its time has come.